All right, I'm gonna come back here into my course and we're going to take a look at building a page and talk about how you can use them, why you might wanna use them. So this is my page that's called Introduction to Pandas. Remember, I can tell that it's a page because I've got this icon right here. So go ahead and click on your page so that you can build along with me. So when I get to this space, we haven't built anything yet. We just have really a placeholder. So we're going to click in the upper right-hand corner on the edit pencil. Go ahead and click on that. And then your rich content editor will open for you. So this looks exactly the same. It's the same tool as we saw when we were building the announcement. And then you also get your content selector, which is there on the right-hand side. So any of those files that you do upload to your file space are going to be accessible to you in here. Right, so remember I uploaded a bunch of those files, they're all right here. So I can use these now in building in my rich content editor, and I'm gonna show you how that works. The other thing you can use your rich content selector for is, or your content selector over here on the right-hand side, is it's going to show you links to everything you have built in your course. So if you wanna reinforce items anywhere as you're building inside of Canvas and say, you know, remember, we're preparing to write our Panda essay. If I clicked on that, it's going to import that link, and students would be able to, from here, get to that link in my course. So everything as you're building in your course is being added to this links section. It's also going to show you things like your syllabus or your announcements. So anything that's a part of your course will show up over here. Just for easy creation. Now, a page in Canvas is a way to deliver information to students. The reason why I like to use them is it's natively built content inside of Canvas. And I'm going to use these tools that are here, the Canvas tools, the rich content editor. And for my students then who are working on a mobile device, if it's built into anything that's used in the Canvas native tools, I can rest assured that they're gonna have a really great experience on their mobile device, just because I'm using the interface that Canvas has built. The Canvas student app, I do think that a lot of your students will want to use it. It is a fully functional app. There, everything you can do in Canvas, you can do on the app. And I know that there's a lot of students who really try to experience the full course through the app. So I do think that it's something that your students will want to use.